remind you, please remember to pick up a yellow sheet when you come in. And please now join in singing our opening song, which is on the yellow sheet, By Our Love.
And sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. Lord Jesus, you healed the sick. Lord, have mercy. You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy. You plead for us at the right hand of the Father. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen.
Let us pray. Almighty, ever-living God, direct our actions according to your good pleasure,
that in the name of your beloved Son, we may abound in good works. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
Today's readings can be found in your gather book, 987. A reading from the book of the prophet Jonah. The word of the Lord came to Jonah, saying, "Set out for the great city of Nineveh, and announce to it the message that I will tell you." So Jonah made ready and went to Nineveh, according to the Lord's bidding. Now Nineveh was an enormously large city. It took 3 days to go through it. Jonah began his journey through the city and had gone, but a single day's walk announcing, 40 days more and Nineveh shall be destroyed. When the people of Nineveh believed God, they proclaimed a fast, and all of them, great and small, put on sackcloth. When God saw by their actions how they turned from their evil way, he repented of the evil that had been threatened to do to them. He did not carry it out. The word of the Lord. A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. I tell you, brothers and sisters, the time is running out. From now on, let those wives act as not having them, those weeping as not weeping, those rejoicing as not rejoicing, those buying as not owning, those using the world as not using it fully. For the world in its present form is passing away. The word of the Lord.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. After John had been arrested, Jesus came to Galilee proclaiming the gospel of God. This is the time of fulfillment. The kingdom of God is at hand. Repent and believe in the gospel. As he passed by the Sea of Galilee, he saw Simon and his brother Andrew casting their nets into the sea. They were fishermen. Jesus said to them, "Come after me, and I will make you fishers of men." Then they abandoned their nets and followed him. He walked along a little farther and saw James, the son of Zebedee, and his brother John. They were too in a boat mending their nets. Then he called them. So they left their father Zebedee in the boat along with the hired men and followed him. The Gospel of the Lord. Today I'd like to reflect on the teachings of the gospel about following Jesus, but also to touch on the famous prophet Jonah, J-O-N-A-H, popular boy's name these days, Jonah, and Jonah's prophetic narrative. Jonah is also sent on a mission by God, sent out with a divine message. In the first reading, Jonah is the prophet who is making a decision to either act for or against the people for whom he has every reason not to like. There's lots of reasons not to like Nineveh if you are Jonah, if you are from Jerusalem and Israel, because Nineveh is the enemy of Jerusalem and Israel. Nineveh will ultimately conquer Israel. God knows this, but God in his mercy even reaches out to those who will reject him. What does Jesus say from the cross? "Forgive them, Father, they know not what they do." Jesus reaches out to those who will reject him, and God is giving the people of Nineveh an opportunity to repent and to reconcile. God believed in the people of Nineveh. Jonah does not believe in the people of Nineveh. God represents mercy for Nineveh. Jonah represents vengeance for Nineveh. And the story perhaps is very familiar to you. God orders Jonah to warn the citizens of Nineveh, a nearby city, but also a place that's a political enemy. Rather than traveling to Nineveh, Jonah already has a boarding pass, a bus ticket to Nineveh, but Jonah decides to get on a ship headed out to sea to the Mediterranean. A storm threatens the ship. The soldiers find out that the cause of their misfortune, the reason for this winter storm warning, is because Jonah is on board, and they throw Jonah overboard, and Jonah is then thrown into the sea, and in the sea, Jonah is swallowed by a huge fish. He prays for 3 days and nights in the fish. He's delivered up to land because God commands the fish to release him. Jonah heads to Nineveh, apparently to follow God's original instructions. Upon hearing Jonah's warning, the king of Nineveh repents miraculously. Nineveh is an enemy to Israel. All the people of Nineveh repent, and God does not punish them. Throughout the book, we see Jonah being rescheduled, delayed, and fearful. The irony of the book of Jonah is that Jonah is the disobedient prophet. Jonah probably obeys God on a scale of 0 to 100. Jonah obeys about 39 or 40% of the time. Meanwhile, everybody who encounters Jonah becomes 100% obedient to God, 100% faithful. How are you and I to regard Nineveh in our lives? Who is Nineveh? Who is the enemy to you? Who is the person who is the obstacle to you? A biblical scholar, Brad Petrie, had an interesting video that I saw about the importance of love of enemies and what does love of enemies really mean to you and me. The word love is associated with chocolate, Valentine's Day, romantic feelings, emotional affection. And by the way, all that's going to connect with the gospel beautifully this year because Ash Wednesday is on Valentine's Day. Save the date, okay? But love is not just about good feelings. Because the gospel says love your enemy, but then it says love your enemy in terms of doing good actions, doing good in return. In other words, doing good to somebody who might do bad to you. That's an action, that's not a feeling. Love an enemy means do not curse the other person. In other words, if you are cursed by somebody, return a blessing instead. That's an action. Love an enemy says pray for your enemies. Prayer is an action and a challenge. Now, I just mentioned doing good, blessing the other person, and praying for the other person. It's kind of like a multiple choice test, though. You can't necessarily, you may not be able to do all three, but maybe you can do at least one or more of the three for somebody who has hurt you, somebody who has harmed you, somebody you might be afraid of. Sometimes it's not safe to be in the presence of somebody who's really harmful to you, but you can still pray for that other person. The person whom you might feel hurt by may have died. You can still pray for the eternal rest of someone who has died, someone who has harmed you. So in this regard, the golden rule is raised to a new level. Jesus takes the golden rule to a new level to do good to those who harm him. Forgive them, Father, they know not what they do. But does that only apply to Jesus? I think it applies to you and me as well. For example, The reason that I want and need people to love and do good to me is because sometimes I do bad to you. And I am grateful for those who do good to me, even those I do bad. Thank you. Sometimes I don't speak well of you or of someone else, and someone, that person or you, speaks well of me. Thank you. There may be times when I go off the rails or maybe going down the wrong path, and you have prayed for me. Thank you. That applies to me, but it may apply to somebody else in your life who has done bad to you, needs you to do good to them, somebody who has cursed you, and you could bless the other person, or somebody for whom you can pray. This is what it means to become a disciple, to love those who do not love us in return. At this time of year, we also extend our prayers to the pro-life movement, to those who work for the protection of unborn children, for those who work for the protection of potentially sick people or elderly people who might be victims of euthanasia. We pray for the protection of human life at all stages, recognizing that there is the protection of life from conception through natural death. And that the defense of vulnerable lives involves not only loving those who love us, but also doing good and returning blessing to those who may cause difficulty, may become an obstacle in our lives. We pray for ourselves, we pray for those who love us, and we pray for those even who do not love us through this gospel message.
Nicene Creed, I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified.
Let us pray to Christ the King, the firstborn of all creation.
That we may be awake to the Lord's coming and God's presence in the church, we pray. For all who suffer an illness and need health and strength, we pray. For those who govern, may they acknowledge the power of God to give new life and work to protect the dignity and sanctity of human life from conception through natural death, we pray. For our beloved deceased, Debbie Denisi, John Bioi, Gerald Kehoe, Teresa Kehoe, Joanne Hoppler, and for all who remember our parish book of life, we pray. For the intention of this Mass, for the internal rest of Nancy Lynch, we pray.
Heavenly Father, hear these prayers, and as we keep in the silence of our hearts through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Sorry.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Accept our offerings, O Lord, we pray, and in sanctifying them, grant that they may profit us for salvation through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is
truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you laid the foundations of the world and have arranged the changing of times and seasons. You formed man in your own image and set humanity over the whole world and all its wonder, to rule in your name over all you have made and forever praise you in your mighty works. Through Christ our Lord, and so with all the angels we praise you, as in joyful celebration we acclaim. Gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." When supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." As we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and Joseph our Bishop and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Our Lady of Lourdes, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
By divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory of Jesus, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Thank you. Let us pray. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that receiving the grace by which you bring us to new life, we may always glory in your gift, through Christ our Lord. In a couple of weeks, we will be starting the annual appeal with the Archdiocese for 2024. Our goal for this year is the same as last year, $28,210. Last year, we made our goal. We exceeded our goal. We got a rebate. Great job. Thank you. We're very grateful to all of you. We need your support, and we can definitely make the goal this year. If we make the goal by June 30th, we get another benefit. We reduce our expenses to the Archdiocese by about $15,000. So please help us make the goal by June 30th. More information is to come, and just pray for the success of our campaign. If you have any questions, please let me know, but more information will be forthcoming. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Go forth in peace. The Mass is ended.
Please open your hymnal to number 517 and join in singing praise to you, O Christ, our Savior.